Alright, so the recipe we're making today is called a 10-minute apple crisp. It's just a recipe for apple crisp for one, but it's pretty easy to duplicate if you need to make it for more people. But it's really good if you just got a couple apples left, or if there's just a couple of you, or just one of you that wants a little bit of apple crisp. So, some of the things that you'll need, these are all the ingredients here. You'll need flour, regular sugar, brown sugar. The recipe actually calls for apple juice. I like to use orange juice. It gives a little bit of a tartness that is pretty good. But apple juice is a good substitute. Some rolled oats, cinnamon, salt, butter, and a peeled apple. So what you want to do is you want to take, and you'll actually want to take your apple and you'll have it peeled. And then what you want to do is you actually want to core it. I use a lemon baller to core it because I don't want it to go all the way through. I want there to be some room in there. You'll see why later. So just take a regular melon baller and start to ball it out. Like so. After a little while, you'll see where the seeds are. You want to get just past where you've got all the seeds out. So I'm digging in there a little bit. You can kind of gauge, if you know how big a ping pong ball is, that's about the size of size of cavity that you want in here. So we're about there. Just a little bit more, okay? So we've got all that out. Now what we want to do is we'll just set that. Actually, I'm going to make this a little bigger in there. Okay. Alright, so now you want to take your ingredients. You'll want 1 teaspoon of flour. Take that. And just put it in a bowl. Make sure this is a microwave-safe bowl because you're going to be putting it in the microwave later. So just put 1 teaspoon of flour. Okay? And then 1 sort of heaping tablespoon of oats. Get just a little bit more in there. Like lots of oats in there. And then 1 tablespoon of brown sugar. And make sure it's pressed down so that you get that whole tablespoon in there. Okay. And then 1 tablespoon of butter. Before you start the recipe, make sure that your butter is soft. You don't want it melted, but you definitely don't want to just pull it out of the fridge either. So 1 tablespoon, there's little markers on the side that tell you how much a tablespoon is. And grab it here. I usually just cut it with a fork. If you can cut it with a fork, then it's probably soft enough. Just put it in there. And then calls for 1/8 teaspoon of salt. So I'm just going to give a little couple dashes there. And then 1/4 teaspoon of cinnamon. So do a little bit of that in there as well. Okay, now what I'm going to do is I'm going to take and I'm actually going to mix this all together. It doesn't need to be mixed perfectly, but it needs to be fairly stuck together. So we're going to take all that. Mostly just getting the butter spread throughout the oats so that it all sticks together and you can form it into a nice little ball. So it's coming together pretty good there. Occasionally you may need to just do a little scrape. Start again real quick. Okay. So you get that, kind of pull it all together. And you want this to form into a nice little ball. It doesn't need to be super cohesive, but you'll just take it, you'll bring the apple over here, and you'll stuff this inside of the apple. That's why you cored it out before. If it's heaping on the top, that's just fine. That's actually probably a good thing. Okay. Alright, so we'll leave a little bit behind in there. Now what we're going to do, we're going to just get that off a little bit. We're going to take our sugar, we're actually just going to have 1/2 teaspoon of sugar. Okay, we're just going to sprinkle it over the top, like that. We're going to take our cinnamon again, just give it a few dashes across the top of the apple to make it mostly look nice. And then you'll want about a quarter of a cup of juice in the bottom here. You want to make sure that things stay moist. So just enough to give it, you know, like maybe an eighth of an inch of depth in this. Then you take over here. Then you're going to microwave. You're going to microwave it for 4 to 5 minutes. If it's a more firm apple, this is where you kind of have to tell. If it's a very firm apple, definitely lean towards the five minutes. If it's one of these softer apples like this one is, you're only going to want to do it for about 4 minutes or else it'll become too soggy. So you'll take, put it in the microwave. Get that started. I've got one here that I did just a little bit ago. Come and take a scoop of ice cream. It's ready to go. And then you can just use the same fork that you used before. Put a little bit of apple. A little bit of ice cream. And there you go. You've got a 10-minute apple crisp.